Everyone, and hope you all are doing good. I'm working on a project of creating a CoreXY printer. Actually, it's kind of converting my Creality CR10S4 to CoreXY like the VzBot style. I'm reusing whatever I could from the CR10S4, like the stepper motors, aluminium profiles, bed, sensors, etc., and want to share the progress with you all. It's a long journey, not sure how much time it's going to take to complete the entire setup, but we'll see. For now, I had to order some L-shaped connectors, nuts and bolts, and that took time to arrive. So for now, I have only built the frame. I also need to order more mechanical and electronic parts, such as mainboard, fans, power supply, etc. Here, I am building the bottom frame. Now let's see the bottom base frame in OnShape. So this is how the bottom base frame will look like. You have this aluminium 20 by 40. This is 600 mm and the blue one, this is 560 mm. Here you can see I'll be installing this connectors and this L-shaped connectors on the corners, and on the bottom this will look like this. Here I am tapping the 2040 profile with an M5 thread. This is required to install the L-shaped connectors. Here I am installing the top frame or the gantry. So the procedure remains the same as I did for the bottom frame. And this is how the top frame will look. If you see, I have installed the connectors, the L-shaped connectors on the bottom side over here. This is to get extra stability apart from this corner connectors. On top, here the carriage mounting will come over here. That's why I have to do it on the bottom side. The motors will be mounted on top. So the Y will come here, X, Y1 and X1 over here. Here I am installing the pillars, the four pillars. If you notice, it's I'm installing on the bottom side of the top gantry. Now here the frame assembly is complete. I'm installing the base frame, the bottom frame on top of the pillars. Here I'm installing the rubber feet, which are of the original CR10S4. Now the tools that I have used: a set of Allen key, set of hex screwdriver, M5 button head bolts, T-nuts, these are for 2020 profile. We can use either one, this or this. If you use this, you can install it even later. But if you're using this, you have to make sure that you install it prior building the frame. If you miss to install this, then go for this. I prefer to go for this one. But these are better than these L-shaped connectors, corner connectors. Second type of corner connectors, these are high profile. The previous one which I showed, these are low profile. Some carpenter square or right angle, this type, or something that you can hold the profile in the right angle position. You can buy this in AliExpress. You get in set of 2-4. I have 4 of these. For typing, I use this. This is M5 threaded drill bit and some clamps. With the help of clamps and this right angle, it makes it much easier to assemble the frame. And last, you need to have a flat surface. I have this scrap MDF which I use to build the frames. And here is the final frame setup. In X it is 640 mm and in Y it is 600 mm. Once the frame is fully assembled, it is good to measure the dimension diagonally from here to here, and the same thing from here to here. Both sides should have equal dimension. That will show that the frame is squared properly. And now let me walk through the 3D model of my printer that I have designed. I have done various iterations from 1 to 9. My initial goal was to keep the design very close to VzBot, even all the parts to be same, not to redesign anything. So having that in mind, I started to create the model. This is the very first model that I created. If you see here, in this one, the on the x-axis, the maximum space or the maximum length I get is, it's around 370 on the x-axis, 380 on the y-axis. So on the x-axis, I do not get the entire space. So likewise, I did different design. I tried to create different configuration with the element profile that I had to see what is the best design that would give me the maximum bed. In this design, this is V3. Here it says 438 on the x-axis, the x movement. But the actual bed area would depend on the nozzle point from here to here. This is version 7. In this design, the maximum x-axis I would get is 388. And on the y-axis I'm getting around 400. On the x-axis, still I'm not getting the entire bed space. But if you look at this design on the gantry, I need to go in this mounting direction. So here it's the 2040 is going outside the frame over here and over here. So if I have to align it properly, make it square, not in this way, then on the y-axis I would lose around 40 mm space. We'll see the next design. So V9, this is the final design that I have. Redesign most of the things, since the my main focus was on to make sure that I get the maximum x and y axis, and it was okay for me to compromise on the z height. So that was my goal. So having that in mind, I had to redesign in the mounting location of the motors, the Y motor X1 and Y1. So the mounting is on top of the profile now, not on sideways or the inside side like the VzBot has. So with that, I had to redesign the gantry and also the mounting of this Z rods, the lower rod and the upper rod. With this, the space available, so let's see. So with here, the nozzle is outside the bed. The total X movement is from 0 to 410. And over here, it's slightly on top of the bed. That is on the X-axis. And on the Y-axis, on the Y-axis, total Y movement is 410. So with this arrangement, I'm getting the maximum X and Y axis, the maximum bed area. Now let's check on the Z height. We are at zero location. So this way I'm getting around 385 on the Z height. Now let me go through the redesign of the motor mount. So I'll show you the X1. So we'll start with X1 motor mount. So here, if you see, this is completely redesigned. If you look at the original VzBot is this way for the X1 and Y1, the front motor mount, and the rear one is like this. The X and the Y, they are mounting inside the aluminum profile. In my design, I had to go on top of the aluminum profile. So this is what the design looks like. Let me hide this and show you. In this design, the location or the dimension of the pulleys the pulley, the idlers, the smooth idler and the tooth idler, they are the same. It's the same dimension as of VzBot. Now we'll see the X motor. So this is the X motor mount. In VzBot, you have this belt tensioner here. I'm using the same thing. Except for VzBot, the screw mounting for belt tensioner is here in this location 1, 2, and 3. Since I'm doing the motor mount on top of the frame, this way on top, I had to redesign the belt tensioner mounting screw for the motor on top this way. So the mounting screw for the motor is on top over here, 1, 2, and 3. For VzBot, it is at the bottom. The screw goes from the bottom side from here and it'll attach to the motor right on top over here. Now we'll see on the X gantry. On VzBot, you have the X gantry this like this, and you have railing mounted this way sideways like this. Since I'm mounting my X and Y motors on top of the profile, that I had to change over here on the X gantry. The hot end remains the same. There is no change in that. Only thing, the mounting of the X on the X gantry, I have changed it to make it on to mount it on top. So this is the redesign of that. So this part I have to design. There is no other change on this belt idlers. That remains the same as VzBot. So that was on the X and Y for the gantry, and now we'll look at the Z movement. For Z, I had to redesign the lower mounting, this lower mounting bracket and the upper mounting bracket. This one, VzBot, you have upper mounting like this, it's at an angle, and the lower mounting is like this, it's almost parallel to the lower profile. For me, I had to redesign that then, because we have this smooth rods or the linear rods. This, the height of this is 500 mm. So this 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This I already have. I had purchased this a long time back for some other project. So I'm reusing that. Since I have those, so I had to redesign that. If I have to use the VzBot mounting, this one, top, then I'm losing the Z space also on the bottom. So Z space I'm losing. So for that reason, I had to redesign this. From the aluminum profile, the height of the profile over here is 520 for this 4 profiles. This also I had existing for some other project. I had bought this, so I'm reusing here. Other than that, the X and Y profile, this one is 600. Two of these are of the CR10S4, and two I had to buy for this particular design for this particular printer. And also these two are for the CR10. I think this goes on the Y axis where the Z is mounted, and two I had to buy. So total expense for this particular frame, to design the frame, I had to buy 4 aluminum profile, the Y axis 2 and X axis 2. Now let's see the belt arrangement. Go to gantry assembly. When I had to redesign the motor mounts, this motor mounts, I had to make sure that the pulley and the tooth idler, they are aligned properly. They must be exactly in the same path or in a straight line, otherwise the belt would go crooked. Now let's see the belt for the Y on the Y motor side. So it starts over here. So it starts here. Goes front side of the pulley and takes a turn this way. Then goes to the motor pulley, takes the turn on the motor pulley, and will come like this inside this bracket, and then go on to the tooth idler over here. So it will take a turn and come straight. This one over here is tooth idler, and then it will come straight like this, and then it will go on to the smooth idler and then turn back and take a loop onto the pulley, the motor, then go straight to the tooth idler, and then we'll attach to the hot end on the front side. Now on the X belt, it starts here on the front side, and then we'll go round to the tooth idler, then to the motor over here straight. Now over here you have to make sure, if you redesign this, the tooth idler and the pulley, they have to be straight aligned. So the belt should be straight like this. It comes to, or goes around to the pulley, then front side of this smooth idler, and then straight this way. We'll go to the this tooth idler, go beneath the between the bracket, straight to the motor pulley over here, around, loop it back, and come to the smooth idler. Over here also you have to make sure that smooth idler and this pulley are aligned. It will not be straight, but it will be an offset. So that is why when you redesign this, you have to take all these parts into consideration. So the belt will go around smooth idler, and then we'll attach the hot end. From the hot end side, there is no change at all. It's the same exactly. There is no change in that. I also need to purchase the lead screw. So that is this one, this, and this. The existing lead screw of CR10S4. That's at the height of 518 or 520. If I use that, it will go right on top, and it will hit the X gantry movement over here on this mounting. So for that, I need to buy this lead screw. So the required height for this is around 500. I think it's 470. This height is 470. 470 to 500 is required for mounting the lead screw. This is the original VzBot mount for dual Z axis. This remains the same. This coupling will be from CR10. It comes with two lead screw, two Z lead screw. So I have two couplings. Also the trapezoid, this trapezoid is also from existing, from my existing stock. This coupling I need to buy. This is, I think, the Oldham coupling. This I need to purchase. So that's it for now. This is the design I have completed so far. I still yet to complete the remaining design, the panels, the front door, the back cover, the electronics, they will go here, and the top cover, that I have to design now. So it's a, like I said, it's a long journey, so it will take some time. And lastly, I would like to thank Wes and his team, the VzBot team, for having such a good design. I initially intended to create VzBot, but due to the limitation, I had to redesign most of the gantry and the Z mounting. So that's it for now. Thank you guys. God bless and stay safe.